All right, so I think I'm back to YouTube, kind of. Not really. I don't know how long this will carry on for. How many more reactions I will do in the upcoming future? But I'm here right now, reacting to two KERO singles. I believe Neon Love Song and Maybe I. So I'll be reacting to these two, just like normal. Just pretend I wasn't gone for like 8 months, 9 months, whatever it was. But yeah, I'll be reacting to these two songs. Generally, in the past, my interest in color base has kind of gone down a bit. I think as the genres become more standardized and more people have taken part in it, the quality and uniqueness of many things within color base have gone down a bit. And I just haven't been as interested in listening to color base music. But Kira's my dude, right? So I gotta listen and hear what he's cooking up today in modern era. In the modern era to kind of keep up and keep ahead of the trends. So let's go listen. I haven't listened to these two yet. Just because I mean, this one's from April. This is like 2 months old. But yeah, let's get into it. Hopefully my camera won't lag too much. That's my hope. Nice pluck so far. Sounds like a splice, good old splice vocal. I think the chord progression is pretty solid, and it's kind of like that kind of color trappiness kind of feel that you kind of get back in Radio Silence, but it's more standardized to the more kind of regular general color base kind of ambience and chord progression and that type of sort of vibe that you get from that type of stuff. So this is really good. That chord progression. I don't know. I'm not a huge fan of the vocal, but that's just a minor critique. Overall, it's very well produced, as always, as it should. But you know. Like this, that kind of this kind of like 8 bars, just that kind of ran through the first bit. Oh, ignore this. This is the application I'm using to get my cam my head my candle. I can't speak to get my head on the face. Anyways, it kind of reminds me of like good old NCS style tracks and intros and stuff, from back in the day. It just kind of has that kind of nostalgia reminiscence and. Yeah, not a huge fan of that vocal. But diving right back into it. I love Future Bass so much, so. I knew it was coming. We can make this work. Yeah. I like the vocal more in this context. Good outro. Solid. All right, had some technical difficulties, so I had to cut there. But anyways, just overall, two thumbs up for me for that track. Honestly, that second drop with the first drop or first part of that drop being kind of this kind of future bass. I'm a huge sucker for future bass. So anytime I hear something that's really, really well done, it isn't just like generic Illenium or that type of stuff. It kind of hits differently for me, especially it kind of had some of those old style NCS future bass vibes, and also had like the production and kind of sound design in some parts of like some of the stuff off of Simulation by Virtual Riot. So having those two kind of mixed together was like really, really satisfying, since it was just kind of the sound design and production and the best of both worlds. It was really supreme. And then the next part was just really explosive. And the part after that was just all vibe. So it was like, first you have the combination, then you have the explosiveness and kind of sound design showing off, and then you have the vibes coming in after that. So overall, really, really solid for me. Next track is maybe a little glitch in the camera or whatever, or freeze while I'm switching over, but yeah, maybe I.
Say it's easy. I was holding on to a
With DNA KM, I still don't know if there's. If that's just how you say the name.
This. I'm still crying while I'm still healing. And I hate that I've been crying.
Always, always great vocals. Kind of build up and progression is really solid. Before it goes into whatever next section, I just always like this kind of it's minimalistic. Now it's like it's not giving you that wall of sound, which can be good in sometimes, but sometimes otherwise it's just nice to have those chill vibes, but still have it be decently hard hitting and stuff. And this is really minimalistic and chill and nice. So next part, I'm guessing though. Okay, a double drop. I figure this would be a bit more hard hitting. I really like the minimalistic of that first bit though. Rapid fire. Yeah, because pretty much no matter where KERO goes, it even if it's like super heavy, still has that chord progression at the heart of things. And I'm really huge about, making sure the vibes are still there regardless of where you go with it. So that's one of the things I always like KERO for, is that in a lot of these times, it just seems to happen that way, even though you go from minimalistic to hard hitting, you're still keeping the vibes at the center of it. We get a midsection, a juicy midsection. More of just a normal voice, verse. Maybe I chorus. I really like that washed out bit.
Maybe I should have
when the vocals come back in. Okay. I'd say definitely. I don't know if this is, you know, this reminded me a lot of whatever the ending song is of the Skybreak EP, Moonglow. Whatever, I'm completely blanking on the name of it, but it's kind of reminding me of that. How it's kind of gets quiet and then builds up to this fantastic. I think it was the second drop in that song too. And it's kind of reminding me of that, especially with the way the chords came in and the vocals were, like, you know, soloed out. And the way the fills come in, too. Yeah, it reminds me definitely a lot of that Skybreak song. I'm, again, completely blanking on the name. Especially with the stripped down piano. Really nice. Sweet. Yeah. I mean, I don't know if I have much to say about that. It's just a good sounding track all around. Kind of, you know, like I said, I basically said everything throughout the reaction. Minimalistic first drop. The double drop was a bit more hard hitting. As I think a lot of people are starting to do that nowadays. You have kind of a good thing to introduce some of the ideas and some of your sound design in the first drop, and then you kind of take a bit heavier into the next level in the second, you know, in the double drop. If you do a double drop, that's what I, you know, see a lot of people doing. And then the second drop, of course, like I said, it feels a lot to me like that Skybreak song. Journey's End. There we go. It sounds a lot like Journey's End by Skybreak and Mizu, and I don't know how to pronounce the other name on that. I'm so sorry. Anyways, it sounds a lot like that, with just the way things build up from the second verse to the second drop, with the big saw stacks and the fills coming in, the more kind of color-based hard-hitting fills within the little pockets of super saw. So it's just a really nice. I really love Journey's End, so I really love that second drop as well. And so yeah, overall, I'm glad I take another listen to KERO. I don't really keep up with the color base scene that much anymore, but KERO has always been a favorite of mine in terms of color base. And like I said, maybe one of those is just because he always knows how to keep those vibes and the chord progression kind of at the heart of most of the music. So I'm really big into that, especially since Future Bass is also incorporated to some of his music. There's, you know, that kind of melodic dubstep drop here, and then that future bass drop and Neon Love Song. So yeah, this is gonna be a long long video. Cool. Yeah, again, I don't know how much along this, or how much I'm going to be around in the future, so don't go expecting too many more reaction videos or anything. This could just be a one-time thing, or I may react to other types of music that I like, or just do other stuff. I don't know. There may be more content. There may not be. Who knows? I know. Have a good, what is it, Thursday? Yeah, it's kind of been, I don't know. It's been freestyle. I don't know. Nobody's still watching at this point, so I'm just going to say goodbye.